from London, and my father found a job in Dunedin. They rented a house at the top of Bellevue Street, Roslyn, and that's where I was born. My father, I didn't know then that I was born opposite the very church I filched my husband from. My husband worked for the Assyrian Gas Company until he started a manufacturer's representative business on his own. They were both keen Christians and very musical, taking a big part in the musical life of the city. My father was a singer and conductor, and my mother was a wonderful accompanist. My father for many years conducted a big choir in Hannover Street. My mother was one of 10 children. Her father being a Baptist minister at Dalston Junction Baptist Church in London. They both took an active part in Hannover Street. My mother gave me and my sister our very early interest in reading stories to us at a very early age and making up stories for us, serials. We'd have a little bit one day and another bit the next day. And so it gave us an early love of books, and she encouraged any musical ability we had, but most of all, she told us about Jesus. That was the most important thing. In fact, Jesus was a tremendous reality to me from a very young age, due to my dear mother. I can remember at the age of 7, kneeling down by my bed and telling Jesus I wanted to give my heart to him. I straightway went out and told my mother I'd done this. After the First World War, there was a worldwide flu epidemic and thousands of people died. Hannover Street Sunday School Hall, this is something many of you won't know at all, Hannover Street Sunday School Hall was turned into a convalescent hospital for recovering flu patients. My mother, who was a trained nurse, helped there, and so did my father. I can remember being allowed to peep in the door and see the rows of beds around the hall. We weren't allowed to go any nearer. One episode during the Great Depression in the early 1930s comes to mind. My dad had a lot of folk owing him money, and he wondered how he would have enough money for him to draw for our weekend supplies. We all knelt down and prayed for money to come, and then went off to school and to the office where my mother did typing to save my father having to pay a secretary at the time. When they got to the office, there was an envelope, and in it was £300, a large sum of money in those days. Some money which had been owing for months. When we all got home that night, my mother said with a radiant face, "Why did I ever doubt? I might have known the Lord would provide." Towards the end of her life, my mother had creeping paralysis, disseminated sclerosis, the doctor called it, and she died while my husband was at the Second World War, and I was bringing up 2 children on my own. So I knew what it was like to be a solo mum for 4 years. She came to Hannover Street almost until the end, and my father had to walk backwards to bring her into church with her faltering steps. People used to tell us that on very bad days weather-wise, they would consider not coming to church. Then we would remember Mrs. Demelin. She will be there, they thought, so they came too. My mother could always quote a text to fit every situation that arose, unless it was Shakespeare, but it was mostly texts. So I shall tell you one that she loved best. This same text that I'm going to read to you from Proverbs was on the front of the wedding program of her great-granddaughter, Lisa Pine, whose wedding we attended at Tiana recently, and who many of you knew when she attended Hannover Street. And this is the text: "In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths." And that's the program for the wedding. And here it says, "In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will make your paths straight."
But he's here for a couple of weeks. Welcome, Dion.